Me likes Joanne. My mate Norman Jewis is back with me. Norman, it's great to have you back here.
Fine.
I spoke to you right at the beginning of the series.
That's right.
And yes, you helped convince me to get a Series 1 4.2 litre. Let's just remind all those at home of what your job was for Jaguar when this car was first created.
Well, I was chief test development engineer for Jaguar cars for 36 years. This was one of 25 models that I test developed.
How many hours have you spent driving E-Type Jags?
Oh, I don't know. It must be hundreds and hundreds of hours, you know.
The finished product. 6 months graft. Dragged it off a farm.
Dragged it off a farm?
Yeah. It was a wreck, mate.
What was the farmer using it for?
Ploughing.
Ploughing.
Do you like the look of it just superficially?
Yes, first glance, it comes up to expectations of the shape's all right. Still got the same shape. The colour's good. The paintwork's good, yeah.
Take a look at it, my friend.
Yeah, yeah, OK. We'll start round the front, anyway. Thing I always look for is the sealing of the rims of the headlamp glasses and that.
Right.
Of course, if you get water in there, that can get inside the headlamp, so you want a good seal in there. These look good, so I think you've done a good job there. Seals here on the bumpers. Oh, that's nice and clean, tidy. Probably a bit better than when we turn them out new, this. It is. And we'll just have a look under the bonnet, I think, shall we?
My favourite bit, this.
See what sort of turnout we've got in here.
That's terrible where that cracks off. You cannot keep that.
I don't think you've done the proper job on these.
Well, what do you mean? I was going to buy you lunch, mate. Not now.
I don't want a sandwich.
You'll be getting a sandwich in a garage. I think your taxi's just arrived, Norman. Are you leaving already? What do you think? What's your verdict, really?
Well, I think you've got a very, very nice car, you know. Not a nice car.
Thing is, though, you're a test pilot, aren't you, really? So you can't really judge a car without actually driving it.
No, this is true.
Have you still got a licence?
Oh, yes. Still got a licence, yeah, with a photograph.
Really?
So perhaps we want to give it a spin.
Would you like I'd prefer you kept it straight. I mean, I don't want spinning, because I want you wrecking it. I want you to treat it with a bit of respect.
We won't wreck it. I mean, we treat every car with respect. But
so I've heard.
Let's go and try it.
Yeah? Yeah, go on. You're itching to, aren't you? This could be one big mistake. I can't tell you what a treat this is, Norman, to have the man who was the test pilot for all E-types driving my car. That's a great sound, isn't it? And it still brings a smile to your face, Norman. I will never, ever take the piss out of old drivers again. Welcome back to A Car Is Reborn. I am with my top mate, yes, Ian Boy Racer McForest. All right, mate?
All right.
Yes, indeed. You'll remember Ian if you've been watching the series, because Ian is the lucky man who's been test driving all these fantastic classic cars. But what do you think of the E-Type I built?
I think, again, you've done a fantastic job, and again, I'm lost for words. I'm really surprised.
You're surprised. I was amazed I could do it, but I tell you what, 6 months ago, this car looked a complete wreck. Oh, yes!
Looks a bit manky. That's a common problem. We've got corrosion in here.
There is evidence of damage to the cage here. This is all split. We've got a lot of problems in terms of rust and things.
It is so lovely taking cars to this.
I've got to take out the radiator, the transmission, the front and the rear suspension. The 4.235 litre heart of the big cat is plucked from its body. The bit I'm making is this door bottom here. This is all rotten as pitch. This is the tool for the job. Doesn't the floor look nice? Boy, does this body look different now.
You're not wrong there at all, mate. You're not wrong at all, no.
So, Lee, what's your verdict on this, mate?
Well, it seems in quite good condition. There's not much corrosion in the waterways. It's obviously had antifreeze in it most of its life.
Next job is to prepare the tintable primer. Now, 100 cans of paint need stirring to make sure it all hasn't settled. There's two ways of doing that. One is using a stick like this. No. The other is to press this button and do it automatic. See that finished paint go on. It's just brilliant. Tell you what, it's hard to believe that just a few weeks ago, this wing looked like a tea bag. Lining this thing up is easier said than done. You all right? We've got about 6 inches to the bulkhead.
Okay.
Ignition key is turned and the choke warning light comes on, and here we go. Yes! The big cat breathes fire again! As you can see, we've already finished this side, and doesn't it look gorgeous?
Oh,
yes, indeed! It's going to take a little bit of jiggling to line up the holes in the chrome surround. You got your hand?
Sure.
Open up, my lovely. There we go. Now, there's one more job I've got to do before I can get this car off its axle stand. Now, what was it? Oh, yes, the windscreen wipers.